Well, I think it's beautiful that you, when you get more notoriety and you're producing more for the mainstream, you can take an SCLC Operation Breadbasket Orchestra, which is, for those that don't know, that's a Christian choir. You can give it the 50 Cent, and he can say on that record, "I'm a neighborhood pusher. I move packs to make stacks, a little weed, a little X, a little crack," over a Christian choir sample, only in hip hop. I love that.
Like, even though you have that and it's like it's a Christian record, but the vibe and feel of the sample is so ghetto and gutter. So to have 50 do what he did on there, it's almost like, you know, like it was just made, it was written for him. After doing the research for the record, you know, and people was like, "Yeah, that's a Christian record." I'm like, "It don't sound like a Christian record." Like, "Yeah, but it is." So you look and it's like the instrumental is only the feel. So even though it could have been something for a Christian, we could have took another record that has that same vibe, gave it to a 50 Cent, gave it to a Fat Joe, gave it to a Dr. Dre, gave it to anybody who spits that hard stuff, and we could have came up winning on top. That's the beauty of hip hop.
What's the main difference between you and No ID's version?
I think mine was a lot harder.
I think so too.
Yeah. Must be up to a rabbit ass mind. Fuck around, kill one of these niggas.
Honestly, I think mine was done first. Because when we did that record, that was the first record he recorded for that album. And it lasted to the end where it's like it got cleared at the right time and it came out. You know, and having 50 on it makes a difference too. You know, Ghost is a whole nother type of artist, but 50 did 11 million before that album. So you're going to get at least 5 million people who probably going to listen and check for the record. You know, so you're going to get a better look.
I just hate that y'all gave money to, Reverend Jesse Jackson? Who goes on TV like all the time and says that the hip hop negatively affects black culture, and then 40 years later, coincidentally, two major music producers use that sample, and he's like $500,000 richer.
He had to make more than $500,000.
Oh my gosh! Don't even tell me that.
Even looking at 50 and what he could have made, I'm like, yo, he had to make at least $700,000 to $1 million from 50.
Good Lord. And I mean, that's so crazy. You get a phone call 40 years later, like, "Hey, man, two producers want to use this. All right, well, give me $1 million. All right, I'm going to go on TV now and tell everyone how bad hip hop is while I got all this money in my bank account."
He was talking good after that. But I had to think about this too. Like, that was a gift and a curse because there was another group, I think the name was Family Circle, that I used for Game, for like Father Like Son. And they got a pretty nice check, too.
Ooh.
And it was so crazy because the people at Aftermath was like, "Yo, we can't find this record. It doesn't exist." So I had to scan the record and the cover and everything and send to them. And they finally got a hold of somebody. And he was like, "Yo, this record never really officially came out." But one of the guys from the group, they called me. And it's like, he called to thank me. He was like, "Yo, that check came at the right time." Like, "Yo, well, thank you." You know? So it shows, like, some people don't say hip-hop negatively affects them. Like, look at Bob James. I'm pretty sure with all the money he made, he's not like, "Yo, this negatively affects me." He's like, "Yo, he's probably had more clearances for Nautilus than sometimes people change their underwear." Every time he turn around, he's got maybe 20 to 50 grand coming for a clearance. And then probably some licensing and, you know, a bunch of other stuff. So I'm pretty sure he's happy about it. He's learned to adapt and be like, "Yo, you know, I have to see the creativity in them and what they do. Because I'm not going to lie, it made me a lot of money." And that's what he said.
Yeah, I had on Kanye West's cousin, Devo Springsteen, and he said that, you know, Chaka Khan can say that she hates Kanye sampling, but she takes the money every time we sample her. So,
yeah, you look at it from that aspect. But I think some of the people, like, after a while, James Brown didn't talk negatively about hip-hop. The people who got a lot of money from it, like even George Clinton and them, they didn't talk negative. They bigged it up. So to look at it, when you're getting bigged up by this, you're like, yo, you know, I think it's good what they doing. Like, yo, kids are making money. They staying out of trouble. And I got paid for it. That's probably what they said.